And now to know the update on what's happening outside the Lahore High Court, let's talk to our correspondent Rabia Mehmood.
They are completely sure of the fact that they will be able to reach Islamabad.
As we are speaking, the shelling has started on media. Now they are shelling and attacking the media. They've thrown stones and they've thrown tear gas into the direction of the media.
That the lawyers are, of course, spearheading the movement, which is now being described as a national movement. How are the lawyers feeling?
Yes, Katrina, they are very, very positive and very, very aggressive almost. And for them, there is no other opinion, there is no other option. And they are completely sure of the fact that they will be able to reach Islamabad and their voice will be heard.
जब फ्रेंड की बट्टा गिरी तो टीचर जब मैं उठा रही टीचर ने पेन मारा। मैंने टीचर को बताया कि टीचर आंग पे हाई हो रही है, टीचर कहती ठीक हो जाएगी। फिर जब मैंने बताया कि आंग से नजर नहीं आ रहा, टीचर कहते मैं क्या करूं।
This is the school where little Malaika used to study and she lost her eye in that fateful incident. Now the school administration wants to settle the matter outside the courtrooms with Malaika's parents and have offered them compensation. And at the same time, they refuse to come in front of the camera and give their side of the story and say highlighting the issue on media is of no use.
People-to-people contacts have suffered considerably after the Mumbai attacks. For the past 2 months, buses travelling between the two countries are almost empty. Masood is going back home to Srinagar in Indian-administered Kashmir after meeting his relatives in Lahore.
These buses are empty. Last time we travelled on 13th, there were some 5 passengers, 3 of us and 2 others.
Official reports say that the number of passengers travelling through the Dosti bus service has dropped from 400 passengers to 50 a day. And before how long this number picks up again remains to be seen. Rabia Mahmood, Express 24/7, Lahore.
The blatant act of violence on March 30th in this quiet countryside on the outskirts of Lahore is hinting towards times where everyone is becoming a victim of fear.
जो कुछ मैं अपनी जिंदगी च पहला हादसा वेखी है ना, ये सारी जिंदगी नहीं भूल सकता। जिस तरह बच्चे कंधा टप टप के आए ने, घसीट घसीट के आए ने।
Naseem Khan has lived in Pakistan for 20 out of his 21 years of life. His family of registered refugees comes from Kunduz province in Afghanistan. Naseem lives in a slum beside Bund Road in Lahore, which is the largest concentration of Afghan immigrants in the city.
अगर लड़ाई नहीं होगी तो हम इस 3 सालों से पहले भी चले जाएंगे, अगर लड़ाई खत्म हो जाए। अगर लड़ाई होगी तो वो तो फिर अगर जबरदस्ती से निकालेंगे जाएंगे, नहीं तो हम भी नहीं जाएंगे।
The plight of the Afghan refugees is huge. But the journey for the host country since 1979 has been a long one also, and the crisis till now has only multiplied.
People do stare sometimes. No, I mean people are used here, but you do feel sometimes an object of a lot of staring. Some people pass comments, especially when there is something hot around, when there's a hot issue. You might be walking on the road and someone might pass some comment because you're a Christian, because you're a foreigner, and because you are a woman. But I can say that they were very, very rare comments. Otherwise, I think that people get used to us. True, we don't feel as free as we would feel in our own country. But then we have also to learn to live with this.
Na razaiyan hai na lihaf hai, kuch bhi nahi. To isi tarah zameen pe sote hain, rehte hain, yahan bhi isi tarah reh rahe hain. Jo pehle so jaye charpai pe, wo pehle so jata hai, phir baad mein jo zameen pe aa jaye. Is tarah jis tarah waqt hai guzar jata hai. Bas wahan se hi nikle hain. Ab to hum yahi soche ki wahan se kyun nikle hain. Rahe rehte wahin pe reh lete, apna ghar to hota na.
While both military and the government officials are predicting the Sawat operation to end soon, here in Javed Nagar, the displaced are in need of help now. Rabia Mahmood, Express 24/7, reporting from the outskirts of Lahore.
Shehnaz Bibi is a victim of the terror attack in Lahore, but her pain is different. Her 3-room house got severely damaged due to the bomb blast.
This is the rear wall of Shehnaz's house, and as you can see in the back, that this wall is completely damaged and it can fall down any time. And this is the place where Shehnaz is going to spend the night with her family. Now that the repatriation process has started, the IDPs are going back home. But during the past few months, despite the efforts on part of the government and the relief agencies, the scope of the crisis has left the needs of many unattended. Rabia Mahmood, Express 24/7, Chota Lahore Camp, Sawabi. Despite all the barriers and obstacles, the lawyers of Lahore are all set to march to Islamabad and see as to what becomes of their 2-year-long struggle.
The heart of the country has been at the forefront of yet another movement. These men and women in black have been rallying at the historic mall since 2007, when Iftikhar Chaudhry was deposed as the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Pakistan. But the road to a free judiciary has not been easy. Lahore lawyers have been ridiculed, harassed, bloodied and battered, but they still march on.
For the first time in the history of this High Court, that police entered into the High Court premises and many lawyers were injured, and they brutally baton charged and they brutally threw the tear gas on the lawyers.